Welcome to Fair Game. I'm Kristine Leahy, and my guest today is a basketball lifer whose career crossed paths with Jordan, Kobe, and LeBron. He traveled from Queensbridge to China and went from malice to Metta. Metta World Peace is here. And Metta, I have a bone to pick with you. We're friends. Absolutely. However, in 2010, your 28'3" with a minute left in game 7 broke my heart. I worked for the Celtics that year.
Wow.
The celebration was already starting to happen and you killed it.
Wow.
I'm not happy with you about that.
Wow. Well, that was a...
So thank you for that.
No problem. I got my first ring. You were the sacrificial lamb. I'm sorry.
And
I needed that ring.
And you shut down one of my favorites, Paul Pierce.
He had a rough night.
Because of you.
90%.
90%.
90% me, you know. But I like Paul. Paul is such a great legend.
I'm actually shocked to hear you say that. I would have thought you would have a different answer about Paul Pierce.
Well, when me and him first started to match up, I was in Indiana and he was in Boston.
Yeah.
I didn't really like Paul.
That's what I figured.
Because he was so competitive. It's not that I don't like him as a person. He's just so competitive. I hate my opponent.
Okay, always.
All the time. So he was one of the guys that I hated. But now that our career is over, you can look back and say, wow, I had a chance to play against Paul.
Oh, respect then.
Absolutely.
You've had quite the career. You've had highs, lows, 2 decades, a championship, 2 names. What stands out to you the most?
What sticks out is a lot of things. Like I came in 99, and I was partying a lot at that point. When I stopped partying, my numbers started to go up. Still was dysfunctional in the locker room. Went to Indiana, Defensive Player of the Year. That was an amazing year.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, the Malice in the Palace was an experience that I never want to
sure
go
was.
Through again.
Okay.
Then the championship was amazing. The Citizenship Award was amazing. I should have had way more, but because I kept getting in so much trouble, I wasn't able to get the awards that I wanted. Without all the other stuff, it would have been a lock. I would have been a lock Hall of Famer. It would have been no arguments, but I have to make an argument for myself, which I am when I officially retire.
You haven't officially retired?
I haven't officially retired.
Why not?
I've been too busy. So I'm starting my own league.
Okay.
Yeah, I got my own league called...
This is news to me.
Yeah, it is news. I'm excited
You're
about it.
You're doing a lot.
Yeah.
What's your league?
Well, it's called X versus X. And the reason I started it was because I can still play the game. But
right.
Obviously, when you get older, they look for younger players and stuff. And I respect it because I played 18 years.
Okay.
But I still want to play. So I said, I got to create a league for myself that satisfies me. So right now, I'm currently... creating a league and putting advisory boards together.
So then will there be no more Big Three for you?
I'm still going to play in the Big Three because I like it. I had a lot of fun.
Okay.
My league is going to go around the Big Three.
Your former team, the Lakers,
yes.
signed LeBron.
Yes.
Where do you have them ranked right now in the West?
I have a dilemma.
Okay.
Okay, I believe Kevin Durant is going to four-peat.
I do too.
So the only way Kevin Durant four-peats and LeBron wins his ring,
mm-hmm.
which I think he's going to do.
Wins his ring with the Lakers.
With the Lakers.
Okay, when?
Kevin wins this year, which is, I don't want to see that, but if Kevin wins this year.
Okay.
And then comes to LA next year and
oh,
wins.
Oh, come on.
That'll be a four-peat.
He can't do that. Okay, wait. So first of all, you said a couple things here.
I know.
If LeBron has Kevin Durant join him with the Lakers.
Right. He's going to
get the same kind of heat that all the Warriors did for having Kevin Durant join the team.
But you know what they're going to get? They're going to get big contracts and big endorsements.
Oh, my gosh. What's your take on the Laker fans who say that they can't root for LeBron because they're Kobe fans?
The Laker fans are diehard.
Mm-hmm.
And when LeBron was in his prime, he still is. And when Kobe was in his prime, everybody was saying, no, LeBron's better. So Kobe fans is like, no way in the world LeBron's better than Kobe.
Right.
So then LeBron comes to L.A., and all those fans are just diehard Kobe Mamba fans. They're like, okay, this guy shouldn't be here, whatever the case may be, because they're just fans. But Kobe's retired, he's having fun, and he welcomes LeBron.
Did you have any intense moment with Kobe, or is there something that you saw that you can share?
Well, me and Kobe, we clashed a lot. You know, he has a strong personality.
Really? I didn't know.
And I have a strong personality. So, like, when he would, like, you know, go at us and stuff, I welcomed that. And he liked when I went back.
So how'd he go at you? Give me an example.
We had one argument in practice, and he was, like, talking trash, you know, because Kobe get rallied. He
yeah.
wanted to get everybody going.
Uh-huh.
So he had talked to everybody, talked trash. You can't guard me. You suck and all this stuff.
Okay. What did he say to you?
Same things he's saying to everybody
okay.
else. Y'all can't guard me. I'm the greatest, all that stuff, right? So he is the greatest. So I'm like, in practice one day, I just said, if Yao Ming didn't get hurt that year, we would have beat y'all. You can't guard me. And you ain't got nothing on me. So now I'm talking trash to the whole Laker team. I'm on the Lakers. Phil Jackson's there. Phil Jackson's like, Ronnie, enough is enough now. I'm like, it's never enough until I say it's enough. And I just like disrupted like 30 minutes of practice.
When you were playing in LA, was there ever a celebrity that was sitting courtside that threw you off?
Yes, obviously always Jack Nicholson, but...
He threw you off? He was there all the time.
I know, but it's just always good to see him, you know?
Okay, all right.
Obviously, Denzel sits right there across. It's always good to see him.
That's a big deal.
Never seen Will Smith at a game. He has those seats. I don't know if he still has them, but he never shows up.
I haven't seen him in a while.
I haven't seen him. But I would say people I wanted to see, Nas.
Okay.
He came to my very last game.
That's awesome.
And I didn't play.
That's not awesome.
That's not awesome, but he was there and that was pretty cool.
See, for me, it would be like Cardi B. If I saw her, I wouldn't be able to play as well. I'd be really worried that I need to perform.
Cardi B is amazing.
She is amazing.
But I would like to see Celine Dion, honestly, or Mary J. Blige, or okay. SWV.
You got a wide array of taste there.
R&B artists.
I heard that you're responsible for setting up Lamar Odom and Khloe Kardashian.
I am.
How did that happen?
I had a birthday party. My friend said, I can get Khloe to come host your party. I said,
for how much money?
I'm not going to disclose how much money, even though she gets way more money now.
Okay.
I don't know if she would want me to say how much she got. So she came and hosted my party, and I was so happy because it's Khloe Kardashian.
Sure.
And my buddy Lamar, who I've known since I was 11 or 12, came, yo, my dude, what's up, man? Welcome to LA. We going to win this title. Yeah. And then he goes and talks to Khloe. And then 7 days later, they're engaged. I think married. Something like that. Like,
I think engaged. And then a month later, they got married.
Yeah, something like.
It didn't work out.
It didn't work out. But, you know, Khloe was good. I think she was good for Lamar.
We have so much more to talk about. Don't go anywhere. Up next, Meta's opening up about the malice at the palace. Stay with us.